Welcome friends, in today's lectures we will revise the basic fundamentals we discussed in last lecture and then the Kirchhoff voltage law and its application, voltage division rule, Kirchhoff's current law and its application and current division rule. So, in last lecture we discussed about the basic circuit elements, resistance, inductance and capacitance. Resistance is basically opposition offered to current flow. In resistance, voltage and current are related by Ohm's law, that is V equal to R I and I equal to G into V. This is how voltage and current are related in the case of resistance. Resistance is energy dissipating device. In this element, energy dissipation will take place. Second element was inductor. The symbol used for inductor is this. V is difference of voltage between the terminal, I is the current. The voltage and current are related by V equal to L di by dt and I equal to 1 upon L integration V dt. Inductor is energy storing element. It stores magnetic energy and magnetic energy stored in inductor is given by half L I square. Next element is capacitance. In the case of capacitance, V is the terminal voltage, I is the terminal current. The voltage and current are related by V equal to 1 upon C integration I dt and I equal to C dV by dt. So, these are the basic voltage and current relations in the case of resistance, inductance and capacitance. Capacitance is energy storing element. It stores electrical energy and electrical energy stored is given by half CV square. So, this is the brief review of what we discussed in the last lecture. Now, coming to the second part, Kirchhoff voltage law and Kirchhoff's current law. So, Kirchhoff voltage law. Kirchhoff voltage law can be applied in a closed loop only. Closed loop. So, in any closed path, summation of all voltage drops must be 0. This is the statement of Kirchhoff's voltage law. Summation of V k equal to 0 when k is ranging from 1 to n. So, if there are n number of voltage drops in a closed path, summation of all the voltage drops must be 0. Now, to apply the Kirchhoff voltage law, we will have to follow some sign convention. Sign convention is, if current goes from positive to negative, voltage drop will be considered as negative. And if current goes from negative to positive, voltage drop will be considered as positive. So, important thing is flow of current. If current I is flowing from positive to negative, voltage drop will be considered as negative. And if the current is flowing from negative to positive, voltage drop will be considered as positive. These are the two important sign conventions. Now, in the case of passive circuit elements, that is resistance, inductance and capacitance, what we assume that current will always flow from positive to negative terminal. It will flow from positive to negative. So, when the current is flowing from positive to negative, voltage drop will be considered as negative. So, in the case of RLC, we will assume that current will flow from positive to negative, hence voltage drop will be considered as. So, this is the sign convention we are going to use in the application of Kirchhoff voltage law. So, Kirchhoff voltage law, important thing, it is applicable in closed path. If path is closed one, then only you can apply the Kirchhoff voltage law. Summation of all the voltage drop must be 0. And as per the direction of current, we will use the sign convention. If the current is going from plus to minus, voltage drop will be negative. Current is going from minus to plus, voltage drop will be positive. In the case of all passive elements, we will assume that current is moving from plus to minus, hence voltage drop will be considered as negative. Now, let us see a network. Here in this network, you can see two resistances R1 and R2 connected in series, and it is driven by a voltage source Vs. So, this network is closed network, and in closed circuit current will flow. So, here let us assume that current flowing is I. So, now let us apply the Kirchhoff voltage law. There are three elements: voltage source, resistance R1, resistance R2. So, for applying KVL, start from one end. So, here in this case, in voltage source, current I is moving from minus to plus. So, if current is moving from negative to positive, voltage drop is considered as positive. So, it will be V. So, if we are writing KVL, starting from this to this point, current is moving from minus to plus, voltage drop will be positive. In the case of passive element, voltage drop is always negative as current moves from higher voltage to low voltage. So, plus to minus, voltage drop is negative. In the case of resistance, voltage drop is product of resistance and current. So, voltage drop here is R1 into I minus R2 into I. This is the voltage drop in R2. So, three elements, three voltage drop, summation of all voltage drop must be 0. So, this is how to write the Kirchhoff voltage law. So, for applying the KVL, circuit must be closed one. Apply proper sign convention to write the Kirchhoff voltage law. So, from this case, you can find out the current I, that is Vs upon R1 plus R2. So, series combination of R1 and R2, this is the network. This network is driven by energy source. And when this network is driven by energy source, it will produce some response I. So, process of finding out the response when network and energy sources are known is called network analysis. Next, let us see applications of KVL. So, here in this case, we are first considering the series connection of N resistors. So, you can see in this network, N resistances are connected in series, R1, R2 and Rn. These are the N resistances connected in series. This series combination of N resistor is driven by energy source, that is voltage source. So, voltage source V is driving the series connection of N resistors R1, R2, Rn. You know the basic property of resistor. It opposes flow of current. Here N resistances are connected in series, and the basic property of series circuit is current through all elements will be same. So, here current flowing is I and it will be same because elements are connected in series. So, in series connected elements, current will be same. So, here in this loop, current is I, series connection of N resistances driven by a voltage source. So, let us apply Kirchhoff voltage law. So, how many elements are there? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, as per KVL, summation of all four voltage drop must be 0. So, let us apply KVL here. Current is moving in clockwise direction. So, starting from this point, we will terminate at same point. Current is moving from minus to plus, voltage drop is positive V. Next is the element. In element, current goes from higher voltage to lower voltage, voltage drop is negative. So, minus R1 into I. Second is again element, voltage drop is negative, minus R2 into I. And last, minus Rn into I. So, if we are writing KVL, starting from this, V in element, voltage drop is negative, R1 into I. Again element, voltage drop negative, minus R2 I. again element voltage drop negative equal to 0. So, this is how to write Kirchhoff voltage law. Now, if we can take out this I common, so V can be written as R 1 plus R 2 plus R n into I, that is R equivalent into I. So, now if we consider a network having a resistance of value R equivalent and that is driven by same voltage source, and if we set the value of R equivalent in such a way that the resulting current is also same. So, we will get V equal to R equivalent into I. From this equation, if we compare this, we will get R equivalent equal to R 1 plus R 2 plus R n. So, if resistances are connected in series, their effective value is given by summation of all the resistances. So, if in any circuit or in any network we want to increase the value of resistance, the option is to connect the resistances in series. Now, after getting the current, current I equal to V upon R 1 plus R 2 plus R n. Now, what is voltage drop across R 1? It is V 1. So, V 1 is current I into R 1, V 1 is I into R 1 and I is V upon R 1 plus R 2 plus R n. So, V 1 will be V R 1 upon R 1 plus R 2 plus R n. Similarly, voltage across R 2 is V 2, V 2 is I into R 2. Substituting the value of I, V upon R 1 plus R 2 plus R n into R 2. So, V 2 is V R 2 upon R 1 plus R 2 plus R n, and similarly V n is I R n, that is V R n upon R 1 plus R 2 plus R n. So, from equation 4, 5 and 6, you can see since the elements are connected in series, voltage source is driving in series connection, current is same, but division of voltage is taking place. Out of this total voltage V, V 1, V 2 and V n, this is how it is distributed, this is how it is divided. So, in the case of series connection of resistance driven by a voltage source, you can see division of voltage is taking place. Voltage across first resistance is source voltage into resistance of this divided by sum of all the resistances. Voltage across second element, source voltage into this resistance R 2 divided by sum of all the resistances. Similarly, voltage across this is source voltage into this resistance divided by sum of all the resistances. So, in the case of series connection driven by voltage source, current is same and division of voltage takes place, and this is how is voltage is getting divided. So, equation 4, 5 and 6 are describing the voltage division rule. If the elements are connected in series driven by a voltage source, voltage will get divided according to equation 4, 5 and 6. Now, let us solve one numerical problem based on this. So, here you can see three resistances, one of 1 ohm, second 2 ohm, third 3 ohm, driven by a 6 volt energy sources. Find out the current V 1, V 2 and V n. So, to find out the current, first we apply the KVL here. So, how will we write the KVL equation? Let us consider current flowing is I. So, current is moving from minus to plus, voltage drop is positive, then element voltage drop is negative, voltage drop in resistance is I into R, to 1 into 1, 1 into I, again element voltage drop is negative 2 into I, similarly 3 into I equal to 0, 4 elements, 4 voltage drops. So, you can write 6 I equal to 6, this will give you 1 ampere. So, the resulting current in this network will be 1 ampere. Now, apply voltage division rule. So, voltage division rule, what will be V 1? How will you apply the voltage division rule? source voltage into this. So, 6 into 1 divided by sum of all the resistances. Sum of all the resistances is 6. So, V1 is 1 volt. Similarly, V2 source voltage into resistance of this divided by sum of all the resistances. So, 6 into 2 divided by 6, 2 volt. Similarly, you can find out Vn or V3. Source voltage into this resistance divided by sum of all the resistances. So, it is 6 into 3 divided by 6, 3 volt. So, this is how you can apply Kirchhoff voltage law and find out the response in the network. Next, now we will discuss about the Kirchhoff's current law. Kirchhoff's current law can be applied at any node or junction point. This is the important case. In the case of Kirchhoff voltage law, it is applicable in closed path, but Kirchhoff's current law is applicable at any node or junction. So, how will you define a node? Node is a point where more than two branches are having a common connection. So, at any node or junction point, summation of all the current must be 0. This is how mathematically we can give the statement, summation of all the current in a node or at a node point must be 0. So, k equal to 1 to n. So, there are n number of branches terminated at a node. So, summation of all the current must be 0. So, in this case, k is ranging from 1 to n. So, n is number of branches connected at that particular node point. In KCL again, we will follow some sign convention. So, there are two sign conventions we will be following. If the current is entering into the node, current is increasing into the node, it will be treated as positive. And if current is leaving the node, it is coming out of the node, it will be treated as negative. So, important thing about the Kirchhoff's law is that it is applicable at any node or junction point. A statement is summation of all the current at a node must be 0, and the sign convention that we will follow is if the current is entering into the node, it will be treated as positive, and if the current is leaving the node, it will be treated as negative. So, this is the fundamental about the Kirchhoff's current law. Now, let us see practically. So, this is the node point. Let us define this node as node n. How many branches are meeting at this node? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, it is the meeting point of 4 branches. So, it will be called as node. Now, in branch number 1, current I 1 is going out of the node. Current I 2 is entering into the node. Current I 3 is entering into the node. Current I 4 is going out of the node. And Kirchhoff's current law says that summation of all the current at any node point must be 0. So, summation of these 4 currents I 1, I 2, I 3 and I 4 must be 0. Now, for writing the KCL, we will follow the sign convention. The current is entering into the node positive, current is going out of the node, it will be treated as negative. So, I 2 and I 3 entering into the node. So, I 2 and I 3 are positive. I 1 and I 4 are coming out of the node, they will be considered as negative. So, I 2 minus I 1 minus I 4 plus I 3 equal to 0, or you can write I 2 plus I 3 equal to I 1 plus I 4. So, what is I 2 plus I 3? I 2 plus I 3 is the net current entering into the node. What is I 1 plus I 4? It is the net current leaving the node. So, indirect statement of KCL can also be given like this. At any node point, net incoming current must be equal to net outgoing current. This is the indirect statement of Kirchhoff's current law. Now, let us see the application of Kirchhoff current law. So, here we are considering the parallel connection of n resistors R1, R2, Rn, they are connected in parallel. and a current source I is driving the network. So here we are considering the parallel connection of n resistors R1, R2, Rn driven by a current source I. And we know the basic property of parallel connection. In parallelly connected elements, voltage across all elements will be same. So here let us consider that all these elements are connected in parallel and voltage across this parallel connection is V. Now this is one single node point. And let us consider this as the datum node or reference node. So this source is supplying a current I, difference of voltage is V. So in resistor R1 current I1 will go, resistor R2 current I2 will go, in resistor Rn current In will go. So these are the currents leaving the node. Why they are leaving the node? Voltage polarity is like this, plus minus, and in passive elements current goes from high voltage to lower voltage. So it is going from positive terminal to negative. So I1, I2, In, they are leaving the node, current I is entering into the node. Now let us apply the KCL. So in parallel connection, voltage across all element is same, division of current is taking place. Let the voltage across element is V and current is in different branches are I1, I2 and In. Now write KCL here. Current I is entering here, current entering into the node, positive. So let us consider this as positive. I1, I2, In leaving the node will be considered as negative. So I minus I1 minus I2 minus In equal to 0. We can also follow the opposite convention. If the current is entering into the node can be considered as positive, then in that case current leaving the node can be considered as positive. So current entering the node negative, current leaving the node positive. So this is the opposite convention. This is just equivalent to multiplying this equation by minus 1. So in some of the cases, in some problems we will also follow the opposite convention. So applying KCL, I equal to I1 plus I2 plus In, current entering into the node must be equal to current leaving the node. So total current leaving the node is I1 plus I2 plus In. So I equal to I1 plus I2 plus In. Now in resistance, current I is given by V upon R. So I1, difference of voltage V, resistance R. So I1 is V upon R1, I2 is V upon R2, In is V upon Rn. So current I is V upon R1 plus V upon R2 plus V upon Rn. Or you can write G1 plus G2 plus Gn into V. What is G1? G1 is 1 upon R1. Reciprocal of resistance R1, G2 1 upon R2, and similarly Gn is 1 upon Rn. So this can be written as I equal to G equivalent into V, where G equivalent is G1 plus G2 plus Gn. So here one thing you can conclude, if the resistances are connected parallelly, their effective conductance G equivalent is given by G1 plus G2 plus Gn. And you know conductance is reciprocal of resistance, so it can be written as 1 upon R equivalent is 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon Rn. So if we want to decrease the value of resistance in a network, the option is to connect the elements in parallel. So if resistances are connected in parallel, their equivalent value is given by 1 upon R equivalent equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon Rn. Now the second equation was I equal to G1 plus G2 plus Gn into V. So we can find out V. V is I upon G1 plus G2 plus Gn. That means parallelly connected resistances driven by a current source, this is the response generated, V voltage across all the elements. So voltage V is I upon G1 plus G2 plus Gn. Now we can calculate I1, I2 and In. So, what is I 1? I 1 is V into G 1. So, this is V, we have got I upon G 1 plus G 2 plus G n into G 1. So, current I 1 in first element is source current into conductance of this branch divided by sum of all the conductances. Current I 2 in second branch, source current into conductance of this branch G 2 divided by sum of all the conductances. I 3 is V G 3, I upon G 1 plus G 2 plus G 3 into G n. So, this is how we will find out the current. So, in the case of parallel connection driven by a current source, voltage across all parallelly connected element will be same, and the division of current will take place, and current division will be according to these equations. So, equation 5, 6 and 7 shows that when a parallel combination of n resistors is driven by a current source, division of current takes place. Rule is called current division rule. Now, let us apply this current division rule for parallel combination of two resistors, because this will be the most commonly used network. So, here we can see two resistances are connected in parallel and a current source is driving the network. So, here current will get divided. So, current I 1 can be written as source current into conductance of first branch divided by G 1 plus G 2. Now, conductance is reciprocal of resistance. G 1 is 1 upon R 1. So, if we replace this G 1 by 1 upon R 1 and G 2 by 1 upon R 2, we will get I R 2 upon R 1 plus R 2. This is the basic equation. Current I 1. So, in the case of resistance, we are writing the equation directly in terms of resistances. So, current I 1 in first branch is source current into resistance of opposite branch divided by sum of all the resistances. Similarly, you can write I 2. I 2 is I G 2 upon G 1 plus G 2, and when we replace this G 2 by 1 upon R 2, G 1 by 1 upon R 1, we will get I R 1 upon R 1 plus R 2. That is, current in this branch is source current multiplied by resistance of opposite branch divided by sum of all the resistances. So, this is how directly in terms of resistance we can apply the current division rule. Let us consider a numerical problem. Here, three resistances, 1 ohm, 1 by 2 ohm, 1 by 3 ohm connected in parallel, driven by a current source of 6 ampere. Here we will write the Kirchhoff's current law, and by applying KCL, we will find out voltage generated across parallel combination and current in different branches I 1, I 2 and I 3. So, write KCL. Statement of KCL says that net current at any node must be 0. Sign convention is current entering into the node positive, current leaving the node negative. So, this 6 ampere current is entering into this node positive. Current I 1, I 2 and I 3 are leaving the node minus I 1, minus I 2, minus I 3 equal to 0. Or you can write I 1 plus I 2 plus I 3 equal to 6. So, what is I 1? V upon R 1, V upon 1. What is I 2? V upon R 2, 2 V 2 plus V upon R 3. So, V upon 1 by 3, 3 V 3 equal to 6. So, 6 V equal to 6. So, V equal to 1 volt. So, this is how you can find out the voltage. So, voltage across this is V, that is 1 volt. After getting the 1 volt voltage, you can find out the current. What is I 1? V upon R, 1 upon 1, 1 ampere. I 2, V upon R, V upon 1 by 2, V upon 1 by 2, this is 2 ampere, and similarly I 3 is 3 ampere. Here we can also apply current division rule to find out I 1, I 2 and I 3. How can we apply the current division rule? For direct application of current division rule, you can convert these resistances into conductances. So, the conductance corresponding to this is 1 mho, conductance corresponding to this is 2 mho and corresponding to this is 3 mho. So, what will be current I 1? Source current, that is of 6 ampere, multiplied by conductance of this branch, that is 1 mho, divided by sum of all the conductances, 1 plus 2 plus 3, 1 ampere. This is the direct application of current division rule. Similarly, I 2, source current into conductance of this branch is 2, divided by sum of all the conductances, 3 plus 2 plus 1. 2 ampere. Similarly, I 3 is 6 into 3 divided by 6, 3 ampere. Now, you can also verify KCL from this. KCL says that incoming current must be equal to outgoing current. So, 6 ampere current is entering into the node and 3 plus 2 plus 1, 6 ampere current is leaving the node. So, this is how we can apply current division rule in a network. One more problem we can see. Direct application of KCL and KVL both. If we consider a network like this, and if we want to find out the equivalent resistance between these two terminals, let us consider all the resistances are of equal value. All resistances are equal value. So, to find out the equivalent resistance, we will have to take the help of KVL and KCL. So, how we will find out the equivalent resistance? To find out the equivalent resistance, we will connect a voltage source V and let the current supplied by this is I. So, source voltage is V, current supplied by this is I. Now, it is a symmetrical network. So, this incoming current will equally divide into 3. So, I by 3 current will go here, I by 3 current will go here, I by 3 current will go here. Now, at this point, this I by 3 current will get divided into 2 branches. So, half of the current will go here, that is I by 6, I by 6. Now, from here also, we will find out the current like this, and then we can apply KVL to get the equivalent resistance. So, apply KVL here in one of the closed path, and then V equal to R equivalent into I. So, this will give you the R equivalent, that is V upon I. So, by applying simultaneously KVL and KCL, so here in symmetrical networks, this approach can be applied. So, we can find out the equivalent resistance by applying this approach. Current division, equal division since this network is symmetrical network, and then use one of the closed path to write the KVL. So, V equal to R equivalent into I, so R equivalent is V upon I. So, this will be approach adopted for getting the equivalent resistance of symmetrical networks. Thank you. Thank you.